I'm going to introduce you to the easiest form of wood turning. The production of these little flowers made out of hedgerow material such as hazel, although you can use other material. Now this is an overgrown hazel coppice. It's not been seriously used for many years, but this is where we're going to get the raw material for today's exercise. Okay, well this is an ideal material. Anything between half an inch and three quarters of an inch, maybe 7 1/8, is absolutely ideal for flowers. If you can choose these sun shoots, that's these nice straight growing shoots, as opposed to some of the more old and gnarly ones, because the sun shoots are going to be virtually knot free. You only need just a small pruning saw or a pair of secateurs, and we'll cut this one down there, and that's going to, I'll saw it off to about there, and then I'll saw it into about 6 inches, so we get three sections there, three flowers out of each section, so we'll probably get 9 flowers out of there. One of my favourite tools for making the flowers is this round skew, half inch round skew out of produced out of high speed bar, ground back about 40 degrees, and the grind is swept back to give quite a narrow grind, quite a thin blade. You can use a whole variety of tools, but you only need the one. So when you've found one that you're comfortable with, you'll find that you'll be able to do all that's necessary with that one tool. So the first thing we need to do is to remove this bark. So I'll turn the tool round. Now this piece of hazel is bone dry, and that will make a much tighter flower than if I was using green material. That's sufficient. I tend on these occasions just to use the point of the tool just to clean the end of the blank off. And now this is the important bit. Once you've got this right, you can do anything. Now the important thing to remember is to use the heel of the skew or whatever tool you're using. Describe it in a parallel motion like that. So from right to left, go parallel. But once you've got the hang of it, parallel motion, using the rest almost as a fulcrum, following that central line as you perceive it with your eyes until you've got a flower. Now parting off, dead simple. Using the long point, make a V cut there, and off she goes. There, how simple is that?